In the Karmakanda, there is competition to reach heavenly planets for better sense gratification. And there is similar competition in the Jnanakanda and the Upasana Kanda. This competition is because of envy. Whenever we want sense gratification, it should be understood that that is due to our aversion to Krishna. Because in the unconditioned status, one does not desire any form of sense gratification. In Jnanakanda, the desire is, as Prabhupada sometimes remarks, the desire for liberation is also a selfish desire. The desire for sense gratification is a material selfish desire. The desire for liberation is a spiritual selfish desire. Upasana Kanda referring to specialized worship of functional deities. That is also on the basis of materialistic motives, and hence it is also necessarily leading to competition. The Srimad Bhagavatam is superior to all of these because it aims at the supreme truth, which is the subject, which is the substance or the root of all categories. So the Srimad Bhagavatam has as its aim Vedyam Vastavam Atra Vastu Shivadam Tapatrayon Mulanam. The Srimad Bhagavatam aims at attainment of the supreme truth, Krishna, who is available for all. And because he is available for all, there is no question of a competition with others to attain love for Krishna, by which one attains Krishna. Because he is the substance or root of all categories, he is the source of everyone, he is also present inside everyone. He is all pervasive. Without him, we cannot exist, we cannot function. And attaining him is the most intimate, congenial achievement of existence. And every living entity, and attaining Krishna Prema, by which one can procure Krishna's intimate presence, is the birthright, or rather the existence right of every living entity. And therefore there is no competition here in the teachings of Srimad Bhagavatam. From Srimad Bhagavatam, one can come to know the substance as well as the categories. The substance is the absolute truth, the supreme lord, and all emanations are relative forms of energy. Relative forms of energy refer to energy forms of energy which are related to and dependent on the supreme lord. He is called the substance. Substance means he is a source. Categories refer to his various manifestations of energies. Shaktiman, Shakti, and there are varieties of these categories, these emanations. Nothing is apart from the substance, but at the same time the energies are different from the substance. This conception is not contradictory. Nothing is apart from the substance, but at the same time the energies are different from the substance. This is Shakti Shaktimad Achintya Bheda Bheda. The potencies of the Supreme Lord and the Supreme Lord, they are simultaneously one and different. This is brought out throughout the Srimad Bhagavatam repeatedly. Srimad Bhagavatam explicitly promulgates this simultaneously one and different philosophy of the Vedanta Sutra, which begins with the Janmadyasya Sutra. This teaching of Srimad Bhagavatam is explicated by Jiva Goswami in his explanation of the Bhagavatam called Bhagavata Sandarbha, also known as Shat Sandarbha or Six Sandarbhas. Specifically in the volume of Shat Sandarbha known as Paramatma Sandarbha, and his supplementary explanation to that. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has referred us to the relevant section of Paramatma Sandarbha, where Jiva Goswami specifically points out that Srimad Bhagavatam promotes what is known as Achintya Bheda Bheda Vada, the Achintya Bheda Bheda philosophy. That is here. In his annotation, his own annotation on his own Paramatma Sandarbha, Paramatma Sandarbha is divided into sections. So, after section 76, that is from section 77 onwards, he talks about the philosophy of difference, the philosophy of non-difference. And the relevant section is here that I'm going to summarize. I'm not going to explain in detail what Acharya Jiva Goswami is writing, but in summary he's saying that in the philosophy of difference between the Supreme Lord and the living entities, there is an abundance of logical argument based on scripture, and this has been exhaustively presented in various writings. And the philosophy of Bheda Bheda, the idea that there is oneness and difference, that is because the Supreme Lord possesses various qualities. And it should be concluded that the idea of non-difference is because it is not possible to investigate about the nature of the Lord's qualities, because he is fully spiritual and transcendental beyond mental speculation. And then there are others who, on the basis of the Vedanta Sutra, they point out that it is not possible to think about the Supreme Lord simply as being different. And at the same time, it is not possible to think about him exclusively as being non-different. So they accept the idea of Achintya Bheda Bheda, because the Supreme Lord's potencies are inconceivable. Srila Baladeva Vidyabhushan also, on his commentary on this particular Vedanta Sutra 2.1.11, he also explains that the Supreme Personality of Godhead is inconceivable. He cannot be conceived through the mind. So, according to certain opinions, the distinction between the relationship between the Supreme Lord and the living entities is one of difference and non-difference. And in the opinion of the philosopher Bhaskara, the Mayavadis, they claim that the difference portion is merely materially conventional or just apparent, and it is not reality. In the opinion of Gautama, Kanada, Jaimini, Kapila, Patanjali, for instance, there is acceptance of the reality of the difference between the Supreme Lord and the living entity. And it is very well known everywhere that this is the opinion of Sri Ramanuja and Sri Madhvacharya also. But in our own opinion, meaning the Bhagavatam's own opinion, this is a commentary on Bhagavatam, he says, but according to the opinion of the Srimad Bhagavatam, according to its own opinion, the relationship between the Supreme Lord and the living entities is one of inconceivable difference and non-difference, because the Supreme Lord possesses inconceivable potencies. So this is why our philosophy is considered to be the philosophy of Achintya Bheda Bheda. Srimad Bhagavatam explicitly promulgates this simultaneously one and different philosophy of the Vedanta Sutra, which begins with the Janmadhyasya Sutra. The Vedanta Sutra and the Srimad Bhagavatam both begin with Janmadhyasya. Janmadhyasya Yataha. This knowledge that the energy of the Lord is simultaneously one with and different from the Lord is an answer to the mental speculator's attempt to establish the energy as the absolute. When this knowledge is factually understood, one sees the conceptions of monism and dualism to be imperfect. Monism is the conception that we are one with God. Dualism is the conception that we are entirely different from God. In the philosophy of oneness and difference taught in the Srimad Bhagavatam, both of these conceptions do not find explicit direct support. The philosophy of dualism is absolutely correct. However, there is qualitative oneness between the Lord and the living entity, and knowledge of that is deemed very important in the Srimad Bhagavatam. So, monism is factually a wrong philosophy. But the idea that we are qualitatively one with God is brought out in the Srimad Bhagavatam repeatedly, canto after canto. Therefore, Prabhupada says the Srimad Bhagavatam explicitly promulgates the simultaneously one and different philosophy. Development of this transcendental consciousness grounded in the conception of simultaneously one and different leads one immediately to the stage of freedom from the threefold miseries. The threefold miseries are: 1. Those miseries which arise from the mind and body. This is called Adhyatmika Klesha. 2. Those miseries inflicted by other living beings. These are called Adhibhautika miseries, Adhibhautika Kleshas. And 3. Those miseries arising from natural catastrophes over which one has no control, Adhidaivika Kleshas, Adhidaivika. Srimad Bhagavatam begins with the surrender of the devotee unto the Absolute Person. So the Srimad Bhagavatam is a book meant for those who have already studied the Bhagavad Gita and come to the conclusion of Bhagavad Gita, which is Sarva Dharman Parityajya Mamekam Sharanam Vraja Aham Tvam Sarva Papebhyo Mokheshyami Ma Shuchah. Abandon all varieties of religion and just surrender unto me. I shall deliver you from all sinful reactions. Do not fear. This is the final conclusion of the teachings of Bhagavad Gita 18.66. And Srimad Bhagavatam begins with a teaching about the importance of surrender to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So clearly this is next level. The devotee is fully aware that he is one with the Absolute, and at the same time in the eternal position of servant to the Absolute. In is one with the Absolute qualitatively, and quantitatively he is different from the Absolute. In the material conception, one falsely thinks himself the Lord of all he surveys, and therefore he is always troubled by the threefold miseries of life. Because we are thinking that we are the Lord of all that we survey, therefore Maya gives us trouble. Daivi hyesha gunamayi mama maya duratyaya bhayam. There is a verse in the Srimad Bhagavatam which I'll bring out here, 11.2.37, very important conclusive text. Bhayam ditiya abhinive shatasya adishadapetasya viparyayo smriti tan maya yato buddha abhaje tam bhaktyai kayesham gurudevatatma. Fear arises when a living entity misidentifies himself as the material body because of absorption in the external illusory energy of the Lord. When the living entity thus turns away from the Lord, Ishadapetasya, for one who has turned away from the Supreme Lord, he also forgets his own constitutional position as a servant of the Lord. Viparyaya asmritihi, misidentification and forgetfulness. This bewildering, fearful condition is affected by the potency for illusion called Maya. This fear has come because of the second energy. Therefore, an intelligent person should engage unflinchingly in the unalloyed devotional service of the Lord under the guidance of a bona fide spiritual master, whom he should accept as his worshipable deity and his very life and soul.